In this exercise, we will review the maintenance procedure for our SPINCAT SC-168. The SC-168 model operates at 5,000 PSI and has a flow range of 0.7 to 1.3 barrels per minute. Before we start the disassembly process, let's take a look at the main parts of the SC-168, starting with the head, the body, the inlet nut, the weep seal, and the gland. Start by aligning the wrench flats on the gland with the wrench flats on the head. Secure in a vise using both sets of wrench flats. With a pick, remove the weep seal. Remove both port screws on the inlet nut. Unscrew the inlet nut with an adjustable wrench. You can also use the StoneAge SC-168-105 open-end wrench. Note the shaft seal and the O-ring on the inlet nut. We'll remove those in a moment. Locate the carbide seat and high pressure seal in the shaft. Remove both with a pick and examine for wear. Note the O-ring on the high pressure seal is off center. Remember this detail when reinstalling the seal. Loosen the body and unscrew. You may need a chain wrench for this. Now slide the body off the tool. Remove the first bearing set. Slide off the brass sleeve. Using a pick, locate the end of the spring that attaches to the weight set. Pry the end of the spring out of the hole and remove the weight set. Repeat the procedure with the other end of the spring and its corresponding hole in the shaft. Slide the spring off the shaft. Loosen the shaft with an adjustable wrench and unscrew. Slide the second bearing set off. Remove the two O-rings from the end of the head. Note the first one is a regular O-ring and the second one is a backup O-ring. The backup has a concave side that faces the regular O-ring. That's important during reassembly. Now raise the tool in the vise using only the wrench flats on the head. This will free up the gland, which should slide off easily. Put the inlet nut back in the vise. Gently pry out the shaft seal and remove the O-ring at the base of the threads. Repeat the procedure with the gland, removing the shaft seal and the O-ring. Your disassembly is now complete. Wash all parts in solvent and blow dry. Begin the reassembly process by installing the O-rings and shaft seals in the gland and the inlet nut. We recommend using P80 Grip-It or a similar lubricant when installing these shaft seals. We'll tackle the gland first. Note, the lip side of the shaft seal faces up when pressing into place. Use the StoneAge SL-105 tool or a spacer for this. Repeat the procedure with the inlet nut, installing the O-ring and the shaft seal. The lip side of the shaft seal also faces up in the inlet nut. Now replace the O-rings on the end of the head. The backup O-ring goes on first, with the concave side ready to receive the regular, rounded O-ring second. With the O-rings in place, grease the head and the shaft seal on the gland. Slide the gland into position. Next, slide the first bearing set onto the head. Note the bearing sets are not greased. This tool uses viscous fluid as a lubricant, as you'll see in a moment. Grease the O-rings on the head and apply blue goop to the threads. Screw the shaft into the head. Hand tighten. Move to a vise and secure the assembly using the flats on the head. Tighten the shaft with an adjustable wrench. Install the spring on the shaft. Note the hole in the base of the shaft to receive the first spring end. Anchor the end in the hole. Now slide the weight set onto the shaft. Locate the hole on the weight set and position the second spring end into the hole. Slide the brass sleeve onto the assembly. Place the second bearing set on the shaft. Anti-seize the threads on the gland and slide the body over the assembly. Hand tighten. Grease the high pressure seal and place in the shaft. Note the O-ring on the seal is off center. Make certain the short side is facing down when installing into the shaft. Leave a 1/16 inch recess to receive the carbide seat. Grease the seat and position on top of the seal with the chamfer side up. Move to a vise and secure using only the wrench flats on the head. Note the gland and the body rotate freely. You are now ready to add viscous fluid. Feel the tool, pausing several times to spin the body. This will help eliminate any air bubbles in the fluid. Repeat until the tool is full of fluid, covering the top of the bearing set. Anti-seize the threads on the inlet nut with blue goop and screw into the body. Some of the viscous fluid may ooze out as you tighten the inlet nut. This is normal. Now lower the tool in the vise using both the head and the gland wrench flats. Tighten the inlet nut with a large adjustable wrench, or you can use the SC-168-105 opened-end wrench. Replace both port screws on the inlet nut. Slide the weep seal into position with the thin edge facing down, covering the weep holes. Your SPINCAT SC-168 reassembly is now complete. Thanks, and remember, you can always contact our service technicians to answer any questions or procedure issues you may have.